Hi viewers, welcome to our channel. In this video, we'll discuss about total station. The total station has become the most important part of the surveying. In this, we'll discuss the introduction part and also components of total station, how it works, and collection of points and analyzing. Okay, and next application and advantages and disadvantages, also precautions. Okay, let's start our video. Introduction. Before 1971, there were two instruments for calculating distance and angle. So at the first time in the 1971, an instrument was released, that is total station, which can read both distance and angles. Okay, the total station is a transit. Transit means it can rotate in a horizontal and also in the vertical direction. Also integrated with a EDM. EDM means what? It is an electronic distance measurement. With this EDM, it can measure the distances, also slope distances. Total station has evolved with addition of many features like installation of onboard computers to robotic total stations. Robotic total stations means we can control by a remote from anywhere in the site. Components of total station. The main parts are mainframe, tripod, prism and prism pole. In the mainframe, we have other parts. You can see in the picture. Just pause the video and take a look. These are very important for handling the total station. How it works? Total station can work with prism or without prism. So first we discuss prism method. In the prism method, you can see in the picture, the emitter sends invisible infrared waves that are reflected by the prism and reaches again total station. So the receiver collects from the prism, and with this received information, it calculates prism's location and coordinates. So it is one of the method using prism. Okay, without prism also we can calculate, and some of the manufacturers are providing integrated laser distancer. This arrangement brings many advantages where points are inaccessible, for example during the recording of front edges and in many position of pipings, also measurement of gorges or fences. These are the inaccessible points. Then also you can do with the total station. How to collect points and analyze? You can see in the picture, the observer has to align the total station lens with an object or a prism and click the measure option. So elevations and distances are stored inside the drive. For another point, the prism has to move from that point and the readings are taken accordingly. Then instrument has to be connected to the computer and file is converted to CAD format, that is DWG format. Joining all the points in the CAD software, we can map the area. In this way, points are collected and analyzed. Okay, in this way the points are collected and plotted inside the AutoCAD. Applications. So in the applications, detailed survey and data collection, also control survey, means we have to establish a series of connected lines joining these traverse stations. Height measurements, remote elevation measurement. So using this total station, you can find actually the height of the tower without placing prism at the point. This is the definition of this principle. Fixing of missing pillars means you can actually find a missing pillar or a point on the ground with knowing other two coordinates. Okay, that is known as stakeout. You can see in the picture, the missing pillar can be found with the known other two points. Resection. Finding instrument's position with reference to other known points. Here A and B are known points, and from the two points, finding the instrument's position is known as resection. Area can be computed of any figure just by giving coordinates of the corner figure. Just you have to give the coordinates of this corner figure, then total station directly gives the area of this selected region. Remote distance measurements, RDM, means the process of finding the distance between two points, that is A and B, and if there is any obstacle between them, then also you can find the distance. That is known as RDM, remote distance measurement. Now, advantages. In the advantages, we'll just summarize quickly. Quick setting of instrument on the tripod using laser plummet. The laser will be at the bottom. You can just quickly set up the instrument. And next, onboard area computation program to compute the area of the field. Means in the total station, only you can find the area. Local language support and automation of old maps. Greater accuracy in area computation. Graphical view of plots. Integration of database and the area of computation at any user required scale. It reduces time and also it measures up to 3 to 5 kilometers distance. The disadvantages are the instrument is costly and skilled laborers are required, and overall check of the survey is done only in the office, and preparation of drawings require appropriate softwares. Precautions are use both hands to hold the total station, and also tripod has to be stable and do not move or carry a tripod with total station fixed. Take maximum care when the tripod is removed from the total station. Okay, this is the introduction and main users of this total station, and if you like our video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, also like the video and share it with your friends. Thank you for watching the video.